Thank you, thank you. It's a great pleasure for me. I'd like to thank the organizers for inviting me here. Okay, so that is a work with collaboration with Sergey and also two students, Gleb Katausov and Sergey Koval. Okay, the motivation. So I'll be talking about taking the continuum limit of the lattice model. So, and actually, if we go back to what is called quantum inverse problem method, first example of integrable quantum field theory was solved by Fadeev, Sklerny, Ekta Tadjan, it was exactly reverse. They replaced the quantum field theory with the lattice model. Okay? But I would say, honestly, nobody gone back. So we want to come back. And so that's the point of my talk. And so the interest to this motivation is different. And I'm not going to go into, for example, mathematical question is about theory of infinite dimensional representation of affine quantum algebras, which is not yet settled out. Mathematicians didn't tell us what are the representations. And there are many questions related to the nonlinear sigma models and so require knowledge of this representation. And here, I'll give an example how non-trivial representation of the quantum group appear in the scaling limit of the lattice model. So we'll consider two examples. Actually, first example was considered by Sergey, so I don't have to. I'll just point some information which is important for me. And our main example will be alternating XXZ chain. It's still related to the six vertex model, still integrable system, but it is related rather to checkerboard where the spectral parameters alternate in horizontal and vertical direction. So I'll talk a little bit about numerical calculations, which were extremely important in our work. And I would say that we made some kind of breakthrough here, because without numerical calculation, we wouldn't be able to. We were using so-called Krylov method. So that's the work. Russian mathematician Krylov did that in 1931, and the paper called "On Vibration Frequencies of Some Large Ships." He was working a lot. A lot of his work is connected with the Navy. And he even translated the Newton original work on Principia into Russian and published in the Proceedings of the Naval Academy. Because naval officer must read Newton in original. If you change the, if you're talking about scaling limit, we have to take a lattice system and change its size. But when we change the size of the system, usually that concept of renormalization group in quantum field theory is illustrated when we replace continuum theory with the lattice system and when increase the lattice size. The obvious problem for Hamiltonian point of view, which Sergey pointed out, that the number of states is different. And how to understand which state flow to which in the limit, so we have to understand this question. Okay, so. But what we know in the case of critical one-dimensional spin chain, which is the case of our study today, in the scaling limit, the energy behaves that's non-universal bulk constant. And that's what is called finer size correction. And the higher correction there. So if you look at this, there's a central charge that the scaling dimension, there are two numbers, which is a level of two of Virasoro model, n and n bar. And because the multiplicity on this level is a number of partitions, we see that the informative part of the spectrum is highly degenerate. So we know only have one level, but that's not enough to distinguish the state. So from the point of the Hamiltonian, if you are interested in a spectrum of Hamiltonian, it would be hard to distinguish the state. Okay, so let me give a very quick summary of what I need from Sergei's talk. So XXZ chain, quasi-periodic boundary condition, the beta state develop factorized structure where this chiral state, W bar, distinguished by pattern of beta roots on different side of the picture, which Sergei explained, or by the can be labeled by apparent singularities of the monster potentials, which discussed a lot on this conference. And so, but that's a special basis, which consistent with the integrable structure. We have infinite number of integrals of motion. And so the eigenstates, the states which appear from the beta ansatz, they are automatically eigenstates of these all these integrals of motion. So I just repeat P. So if you look at this integrable structure with these integrables, so I just listed I1. Which is basically L0, okay? So it's given by this expression where P is related to the total projection of the spin, Z component, which is the twist parameter and winding number. Okay? So the Hilbert space is sum of this direct product of Fock models. So, and the finite size correction, if we go the 1 over the L cube, we can still, because I3 is not degenerate, we can distinguish the state. So, that's what. Now we switch to alternating spin chain. Okay? The Hamiltonian is given here. And that was the subject of the study of Jacobson and Salleur. And they discovered that, well, unlike the six vertex model, where you see the P here, which parameterized the scaling dimension here of the primary states, a discrete set. But what Salleur and Jacobson pointed out that if we study this Hamiltonian, which apart from next neighbor interaction, the nearest neighbor, next to nearest neighbor interaction, and some these terms. So they pointed out that the spectrum of dimensions which comes from the finite size correction will be continuous in the limit of large L. So that intriguing observations, and they built a lot of work which before us. And I said that this part is highly degenerate. And that we have C, scaling dimension, which is in the, but if the scaling dimension is continuous, we couldn't even identify the level. That's the difficulty. So if we diagonalize Hamiltonian, we won't be able to understand what is going on. Okay, so that's Hamiltonian. I introduced Q, which is the parameter gamma here, and N, which is given by the, not necessarily integer, given by this. So, for those who know what is a six-vertex model, that's a brief definition of the error matrix, transfer matrix. We alternate the spectral parameter, beta minus I pi.
Okay, can you generalize this to other alternating way of alternative way to
1, 2, 3?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can.
Okay. So it's always.
No, we don't know what will happen. So we have some. Actually, ideas. Salor has some ideas, and so quite natural. But you know, from first sight, it looks quite weird. But anyway, so the I think that was the first work of Baxter, 1971, published in quite some obsolete journal, where he solved arbitrarily. Inhomogeneous six-vertex model. Okay, so that's the transfer matrix, and the Hamiltonian which I showed is that logarithmic derivative of the double row transfer matrix. Okay. So here's the twist of the transfer matrix before taking the trace, and so okay, so the spectrum is determined by the beta and Zaks equation. Beta and Zaks equation are almost the same as in the XXZ, homogeneous. Then once we know the roots, beta root, the energy is given by this. And one important thing, there is another operator, which also is expressed through the transfer matrix, but it has a meaning of the transfer matrix on a 45 degree rotated homogeneous six vertex model on a 45 degree rotated lattice with the fixed spectral parameter. And this operator commute with the transfer matrix and with the Hamiltonian. Okay, so you know, with the six vertex model, starting from the beta, Leib, Sutherland, Baxter, there were many work and Leningrad school that people were solving beta and Zaks equation and got some ideas. The vacuum state is this distribution, first excited states. We knew a lot. But here we start on the system, we don't have any intuition what is going on. And so the numerical calculation, the Hamiltonian, is a sparse matrix. So the number of non-zero matrix elements much less than the size of the matrix. So the largest chain we could handle is 24 sites. So the total number of the states is 2^24, which is a large number. And so in a sector with SZ equal to zero, about 3 million states. So that even in this sector, which is the ground state lie, in this sector, there are 3 million by 3 million transfer matrix, and we calculated first 400 eigenvalues, ground state, and first 400 eigenvalues. Okay. How it is done is Krylov method. The Krylov subspace, you take arbitrary vector and multiply it by the matrix again and again. Important thing, there are no matrix-matrix operation, only matrix to vector. So the only thing we need to know how to multiply matrix to an arbitrary vector. Okay, so that the important improvement made by Arnaud, the orthogonalization of this space, but basically this, if n is large, that will be the largest eigenvector, and so on. By orthogonalization, you remove this vector, and so on. So the commercial software, we run it on Fortran, and for this, that's Mathematica. that's a 24 processor machine, and it takes about one day. Well, but 26 processor is a huge acceleration. So it's a huge acceleration. And one important thing, once we diagonalize the Hamiltonian, we also diagonalize the Q operator. Q operator has explicit construction as a trace of the auxiliary space across the letter auxiliary space, a special transfer matrix. But it is a dense matrix. We cannot use any numerical method for the dense matrix of this side. But once we know eigenvector, Hamiltonian is still degenerate, mostly fourfold degenerate states. To diagonalize cooperator on this in this subspace, we need to generalize 4x4 matrix, which is easily done, but it takes about 2 days for 400, which is not bad. So actually, at some stage, we realized that we need a lot of data, and I hope we'll be able to put it on the web and give a public access to all these numbers. Okay, so the vacuum state. The vacuum state is almost as in the XXZ chain, but we have two lines, the root are real on this line and shifted by I pi on 2. So that's basically with the alternation. We have two distributions. And interesting state, that's the law. The next state by energy is given by this pattern. The roots are on these two lines exactly, but the number of roots on the top is more, twice, two roots more. Okay? And so remember, I introduced the operator B, this operator B, which is called quasi-shift operator, which compute with transfer matrix. And these people noted that if you take the logarithm for these states of this type, where the roots on two lines, and m, small m, is the difference between the number of roots on two lines, the eigenvalue of S is given by approximately this, by this formula. Okay, so we don't have any intuition about this operator, how its spectra look like. And I must tell that Hamiltonian is not Hermitian, but low energy eigenvalue for some reason are real, and though not all of them. So if you look at the finite size correction, so the most important part, this delta, is given by the term we had before with P. P is exactly the same as a six vertex model, plus S, that the same S as here. So it looks like we have two Fock space with two Bose fields. And for the first Bose field, the parameter P is quantized. So it's a compact field. And this, for the second field, parameter S, which is zero momenta, is continuous. Because if you take L very large, and M, you can take M large as well, but keep that thing fixed, so we can, in the limit, we can get any number. Okay, so the story repeats. So we have, instead of quantum KdV, we have quantum AKNS integrable structure, which was studied by Lukyanov and Fatiev. And we have a Schrodinger equation for the vacuum state, which is almost the same, except we have another term. That is a spectral parameter here. We can generalize, I'll show it later, monster potentials for this differential equation. And I'll show it later. But let's now concentrate on this formula. Well, this formula resembles, so far we're talking about particular set of states, which look like the vacuum states for the conformal field theory with two Bose fields. Okay. So, well, it looks like quantization condition, some quantization condition for a particle, quantum mechanical particle moving on the line on the segment of the length log L. Okay. And indeed, actually, Inclev, Jacobson, and Salleur did a lot of numerical work and found the more precise formula for this quantization of this parameter S. Parameter S is eigenvalue of the logarithm of the eigenvalue of the operator B. And so they found numerically, they didn't have explicit expression for the constant L0, but that's not that important. So they found that the formula works very good. Okay? And the reason why they wanted to study this formula, because it appeared previously. And, okay, so, but the idea that it appeared previously in the context of string theory. And I'll talk about this a little bit later, but we don't actually understand what is this operator B and how its eigenvalue should look like. So for this 400 eigenvalues we diagonalized, we calculated eigenvalues of this operator B, and they are plotted here. So the L is a half of the length of the chain, so L8. So they're different colors. So the real value of S, which correspond to these numbers on the for this vacuum state I discussed, they're real. But there are a lot of other eigenvalues here. And so currently we don't know what will happen with the spectrum of this operator. We know that some states, when L is increasing, they flow towards the real axis for some states. That's, and we actually can, I think, argue that it is happening. But also we know some states which are flow to the imaginary axis. But anyway, so so the conclusion we make at this stage that at large value of L, the state develop factorized structure where the S and P label the vacuum states. Okay. And the value of L determined by the quantization condition. So if you come back to this formula, when M goes to infinity, L goes to infinity, the neighboring values of S become dense. So, and using this formula, differentiating with respect to M, we can obtain the density. Density of roots on the real axis for the vacuum states. Okay. And so, that's what. Jacobson and Salleur and Clef Jacobson did. And they're wanting to obtain this formula because it appeared previously in the work of Maldacena and Aghori and Sun. And they said that's the density of the primary states in a conformal field theory describing two-dimensional black hole. Okay, so that two-dimensional black hole is a conformal field theory with this action. And it corresponds, it's a sigma model, which where the target space is a 2D cigar. And actually, if you, with, when phi is the coordinate along this cigar, when phi is large, the tangent is 1, hyperbolic tangent is 1. So it's a two free fields. So we can prepare excitation of free fields, and they will flow towards the tip of the cigar and reflect back. And that thing which comes from the scattering phase of the scattering on the black hole with some kind of cutoff on the right side. I don't want to go into that, but Redo wrote down this formula for the density of primary states in a conformal field theory related to dimensional black hole. You know, the black holes now very popular. Recently we heard that the first ever photograph of black hole, they're on the news. And I made the first ever photograph of two-dimensional black hole. Actually, I never knew that there are some vegetation be there, but it's like a really existing black hole. And so the conclusion was, so in the limit, the Hilbert space of the model will be like this, direct sum of this Verma models, Fock spaces with these parameters, with the integral over S with that density. So how to derive this? Well, now we need to use ODE IQFT correspondence. So we have the differential equation. That's the differential equation with the apparent singularities. That's the algebraic equation, which almost the same, but a little bit different. So apart from this S, we have one here. And the numerical calculation suggests that the number of solutions of this algebraic equation is equal to partition of number of partition of the integer n into integers of two kinds. That's exactly what we need for the case of two Bose fields. And so by using this differential equation, we can, using WKB approximation, we can actually calculate the asymptotics of the connection coefficients between solution normalized at zero at infinity, the asymptotic expansion into at large value of the parameter lambda. Lambda is e to the minus 2 beta, the spectral parameter. So for the vacuum states with non-zero m, we have the following picture: certain number of roots here, certain number of roots here, okay, and m. It's a better play, okay. So and m is the difference between number of roots. So let's take contour or integral of logarithmic derivative of this connection coefficient. Okay. with this contour. Okay, we know that's count number of zeros, because a solution of the Bethe-Ansatz equation is just zeros of this function. So that will be exactly 2 pi I L. Okay, so now take this formula and substitute it here. And if you do it, we just obtain the quantization condition, which I showed for the this one. This, let me show. This one. So because the place where the roots become dense and cancel out here, but what is important, how the asymptotic behave on the on these edges. So in this way, we not only can do that for these simple states, but we have can do that for the excitations, for the excited states, which have slightly different root pattern. And what we observed, actually, that the quantization condition changed. It's not the same condition for the states on level 0 and state on level 1. Here we have a comparison of the numerical data, which is given by this which comes from numerical calculation, the value, eigenvalue of the operator S, and analytical prediction. On the real axis, that's the formula I showed. So at that and on the here, the complex value, it's for the level 1. When L goes to infinity, our analytic formula tells that these points will move to the real axis, and in a limit of large L, everything will become real. But the density, final density of the states will be slightly different. So that's the proposed formula for the density state on the level n, and n bar for the right and left chiral components. And so if there will be no, so the direct sum of Verma modules, there would be only the first term, the density of vacuum state multiplied by multiplicity, P2 is the number of partition or on a given level. But actually that's not the case. We have correction. If it is on level 1, we have this. On level 2, we have this. And these numbers are in perfect agreement with numerical calculations for L equal for the length 24. Okay, so I wanted to show you the other how the Bethe roots. Without numerical calculations, it would be very hard to guess what the pattern of the root look like. And without this, you cannot move further. You cannot generalize it for larger value of n. So that here we have on the left side we have vacuum state, and here the state on the level 1. One of the two states. And here, one of the states on the level 2. So, okay, so the conclusion is the scaling limit of an homogeneous six-vertex model does indeed lead to a conformal field theory with continuous spectrum of scaling dimension. And so the calculation of the density of the states on each level can be made possible due to a ODE IQFT correspondence, and that numerical calculation will also very helpful because they give excellent overview of the structure of low energy state of the Hamiltonian. Well, thank you very much.
You don't have it, or?
No.
It's full.
You know, it's a very hard. I honestly don't understand what exactly is written in these papers from string theory. So what they calculate. But okay, but certainly the formula for the vacuum state appeared there. And that is basically the formula for the scattering phase for the black hole, which Zamolodchikov and Zamolodchikov wrote down without two gamma functions. And so, but these gamma functions are exactly as the Liouville scattering phase on the Liouville wall. So if you remove these two gamma functions, you get this formula. So.
For the cigar, right? You see, in the cigar, right? Yeah. The S here is carrying momentum, but in the cigar, the sign of S is not well defined because you have reflections. So it's not the sign is not measured on the S squared, the function squared. In this spin chain, we clearly can distinguish the state is S plus and minus. So the symmetry, so that if even the best scenario you can imagine, that actually should factorize for sensor to symmetry, at least. But in my opinion, this is nothing to do, this model is nothing to do well with the black hole. It's, well, if you see the density of states is different than the. But another possibility that was written in Maldacena, maybe not the end of the story. When you see that what's written actually that is really at this stage. Maybe it's we just need to re-examine the problem because there's certain assumptions for me. It's
But one thing we can definitely say that the limiting structure of the Hilbert space of the system is not a direct sum of Virasoro model, of the product of Virasoro model.
More questions? Thank you.